worshiping him because you love him. Hallelujah. Then shout unto the Lord. Give him a shout offering this morning. Hallelujah. Give him a shout offering this morning. Hallelujah. We're offering him our praise. Glory to God. I love him because he cared. I love Jesus because he cared for me. Hallelujah. I love him because of all that he has done for me. I love Jesus. Hallelujah. Because he cared for me. I love him. I love him. I love him. I love Jesus. I love Jesus. I said I love Jesus. Hallelujah. I love him because he gave his life for me. He cared enough to die for me. I love him. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. I'm going to tell the world all about him because he cared for me. I love him. Oh, glory to God. What a mighty Savior. What an awesome ruler. What a wonderful counselor. What a mighty God. I love him. I love him. I love him. I really love Jesus. I love him. Hallelujah. There is no other. There is no other that I can love like Jesus. Because he gave his life for me. I want to greet the church this morning in the name of Jesus Christ, our one and only soon coming King, the one who promised and cannot fail that he's coming back again to take us with him. Hallelujah. So that we can live forever in his peace, in his love, in his joy, in his providence, in his blessing. The one who has given us a hope that is beyond any other hope that we can possibly have. I love Jesus. I want to greet you in that awesome, awesome name of Jesus Christ. I praise God this morning that he has kept and has established and has moved upon and has been with us throughout this week. Hallelujah. We're none of us in here mourning today. Hallelujah. We could have lost so much, but he has kept us. Hallelujah. I said we could have lost so much today. Some have lost their hopes. Hallelujah. The floods came and washed their hopes away. Hallelujah. The waters came and everything that they possessed has been washed away. But here we are today. God has kept us. He has provided for us. Hallelujah. He has not allowed our enemies to overtake us. He has kept us under the shadow of his wings. He has stretched out his arms and he has held us in it. Oh, how much he has done. How precious is our God. How awesome is our Lord. How wonderful is our King. I tell you this morning, we could just keep praising him. Hallelujah. We pretend we don't want to praise him. But I want to tell you, we need to praise him because he has done so much. Hallelujah. We're reserving some of us our praise for when we get all we think we need. But I want to tell you right now, we have all we need. And we need to praise him. Because he's good. Because he's good. And I love him. Hallelujah. Some of us are not here today. We've traveled. Keep them in prayer. Some are not feeling so good. Keep them in prayer. God is still on the throne. And he's still watching over his people. He's still taking us through the byways and through the hedges. He is still covering us and protecting us. Providing for us. Making ways for us. Hallelujah. How awesome is this God, this Lord, this Savior, this Prince, this King that we serve. I just wanted to give God the glory this morning. Father, as I stand in your presence, Lord, I ask right now, Holy Spirit, that you will come. Hallelujah. I ask this morning, God, in the name of Jesus Christ, that I would decrease and Spirit of the living God increase. Put the words in my mind and in my mouth. Lord, you have promised that you would give me the tongue of the learned so that I'm able to speak a word in season to those that are weary. Father, those that are before me and those that will be watching this program later on, I pray for them. I pray, God, that you would open their ears, open their eyes, open their hearts to receive your word. To let your will be done in their lives. To, Lord God, lift you up and make you the number one. Hallelujah. In their very, very being. So that when you return, Lord, you will find the people waiting. Your word said those that wait upon the Lord shall be renewed in strength. They shall mount up. They shall rise up with eagle's wings. Hallelujah. They will run and they will never get weary. They will walk and not faint. Underneath are your everlasting arms. Hold us up today. I thank you for this prayer being answered. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let God's people say amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
We serve a good God. I want to speak to you a little bit today from Proverbs chapter 16. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It is a word that I read this week and it just stepped out of the page into my heart. And my topic today is, are your steps established in the Lord?
Amen.
Are your steps, your plans, your purpose established in the Lord? Amen. Proverbs 16 and 9 says, a man's heart plans his way, but it is the Lord who directs his steps.
Amen.
When a man plans his way, not any man, not every man, but the man that is in the Lord, the man or the woman of God, when we make our plans, we should make our plans understanding that it is the Lord who will direct our path. It is the Lord who will take us from one place to the other. Hallelujah. It is the Lord who will take us through our situations and bring us out on the other side in joy, in peace, in comfort, having the strength of the Lord. Psalm 37 and 23. Hallelujah. Psalms 37 and 23.
Amen.
The Lord makes firm and ivy. The Lord makes firm the steps of the one who delights in him. And 24 says, though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, for the Lord upholds him with his hand.
Amen.
Praise be unto our God.
Amen.
When the man or the woman of God begins to make plans, whatever direction we're thinking of going, whatever we're thinking of doing, we should bring it firstly to the Lord. Hallelujah. As people of God, we need his direction. I hear the scripture said, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. Therefore, if you walk in him, even if you stumble or fall, praise God, you will not utterly be cast down. Come on here with me, church. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. Glory to God. The man or the woman of God who has trusted in the Lord, who is depending on the Lord, will find him in their times of planning.
Amen.
Come on, church. See, we can't be like the world. We can't get up and say, we're just going to pack our bags and we're just going to go off to wherever we choose.
Amen.
Who knows that?
Amen.
I have a daughter that lives in Atlanta. And every time I go, she said, Mom, why don't you just stay here? You can do a church here. I'm telling you, Mom, you can do it. There are people waiting, and God bless her heart. I know she just wants to come to church. Hallelujah. Because she has been let down by what she has seen. And when you know the way of the Lord, you can't really abide the foolishness of men.
Amen.
Doesn't mean you shouldn't look for a place to fellowship. So that's my encouragement to her. There is someone somewhere, if you keep praying, who's going to do the right thing like you know it and live for God.
Amen.
Pray till you find it. Now, sometimes I love Atlanta. There's more life there. Things are more. You understand what I'm saying? And when I'm there, I'm all over the place with her and I'm happy. Then I come back home and it's kind of quiet. So when she makes the suggestion, Mom, why don't you just move? God's boy, he's coming a heartbeat. That's what she says. I say, honey, I can't do what I want anymore. A couple of moons back, if you'd have said that to me, I probably would have come home and say, Garthy, it ain't all that here. It's not really fruitful like we want it to be. Let's try Atlanta. Come on with me.
Amen.
Hallelujah. But you see, because when God said to me, go here now, I understood his command. And I stepped out in his plan. Come on.
Amen.
He ordered my steps. He said, I want you to go now.
Amen.
So I packed up my belongings with my husband, who must have heard from God. I said, God has plans for us.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And we came. See, once my feet came, I don't have an intention to move until I hear the Lord say, go now.
Amen.
Ah, hallelujah.
Amen.
See, we're not to run all around. The church, I was thinking about the church on the other morning and how you have the brethren running all over the place. Because here, you can't find what you think you need. Come on with me.
Amen.
Pastor ain't right. Deacon ain't right. wondrous. Because that is not God. Unless God told you, go, then you're walking in your own will. And in our will, we will stumble and fall.
Amen.
And if we stumble and fall while we're in our own will, answer, who will pick you up? So he said, I have some plans for you. And the plan is to bring you good and not evil. The plan is to bring you peace. Hallelujah. The plan is to encourage you in the hope that I have made for you. Come on here. He has already established a path for his people. Don't you understand? We have our steps ordered by him. We are here because he ordered our steps to be here. We're not here because of our own goodwill. If you think you're here because you want to be here, I want to help you today.
Amen.
You're here because God said, I want you to be there.
Amen.
And I want you to be there until I tell you to move to somewhere else. Come on with me, church. Sometimes people don't understand that we break covenant with God.
Yes.
When you come to a church and you take fellowship, look at me.
Amen.
We give right hand.
Yes.
You become one with the body. It's like a marriage.
Yes.
And when I move away from the marriage relationship, I break covenant. Want to know why? Many Christians are in trouble and are suffering so much today. That's because they're out of the covenant.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I broke fellowship because I couldn't humble myself enough to say, although sister so-and-so or brother so-and-so messed with me, messed me up a little bit, I am able to forgive them and to stay in fellowship with the body so that we together can grow and become strong and become one with Jesus Christ, waiting for the day when our hope in him is fulfilled.
Amen.
We can't humble ourselves. As I'm talking about Israel, praise God, and the Gentiles. Hallelujah. After the Gentiles came in, they started to consider themselves bigger than Israel. Yet it was because of Israel's fall while the Gentiles got engrafted into the body. So therefore, the Gentiles ought to be praying for Israel so that they will come again into their right place, and together we become one. Blessed together, having this one hope and this one victory in the Lord. See, when our steps have been ordered by the Lord, we can't go any and everywhere. Come on here with me.
Amen.
The Lord makes firm the steps of the one who delights in him. When we delight in the Lord, although things are rocky, hallelujah, we can hold the fort. We can hold the fort. Glory to God. The thing, the sides are falling off, and we are the only house standing on the cliff. Come on with me. Ah, but our house is not built on sifting sand. Hallelujah. It's standing on the rock. And when everything falls away, planted, we're grounded, we're firm on the rock. It's no time for the church to be shaking. If you got shaky legs, if your knees are weak, pray, call out for help. My knees are weak. I'm feeling like I'm not going to be able to make it. Call upon a brother or a sister that you know knows how to get a prayer through to help you to pray. We are called the body of Christ.
Amen.
When one part of the body aches, come on here. How many times somebody come in and say, I've got a headache. I got me some Tylenol. When you want one?
Amen. Amen.
Well, that's what we're for. To help each other. So I give you the Tylenol so you can get rid of the headache and we can fellowship together. So it is. When we are hurting in any place, don't go off in the corner. That's what the devil wants to do. He wants to isolate us.
Amen.
Oh, poor me. I'm sick and sorry. My knees are weak. Satan is saying, yes, I got you now. Yes, I got you now. Yet. You are a soldier in the army of God.
Amen.
When a soldier gets backed up, his other mate sees him in the corner over there. And there is a soldier that needs rescuing. And there is the enemy coming. And they are standing there. They're not going to turn their backs and leave him there.
Amen.
They're more than one for all and all for one.
Amen.
That means they're going back.
Amen.
To get that one that's over there. He didn't quite make it over here yet. Somebody gonna put themselves out there so they can go and grab that soldier and bring him back with the whole crew.
Amen.
Together we can fight better.
Amen.
Separated we can't, we lose.
Amen.
The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. They are firmly planted. Come on, church.
Amen.
My God, we ain't no little softies. Come on here. We ain't no little fly by night. We're not a pushover.
Amen.
We are soldiers. When Satan sees us walking down the street and we are standing in the Lord and our steps are ordered. Listen here. When he sees us coming and all, I saw a cartoon and I laughed so hard. On my phone. I'm praying to the Lord that I don't use that phone too much. I put it down. I'm like, you know, because it can get you. You're watching one thing to another, and before you know it, 2 hours have passed. And like, oh my God, I should have been reading my Bible or praying, huh? But the cartoon, you had the man of God walking down the street. And there's all kind of little demons floating around in the atmosphere. Did you see it? But the man of God just kept on walking. He's going to his house. Demons are all over his house, and I'm cutting it off. But when he gets into his house, none of the demons can come in because he's fully armored. Oh, hallelujah. When he's walking down the street and all kind of demons around those who don't know the Lord, he walks past them, but the demon can't touch him because he's walking with sword in hand. He's got his head. On. He's got his shield on. Bless the Lord God. He's fully armored. The enemy can only flutter around. He can flutter, but he can't touch when you're ordered by the Lord. See, that's the danger of stepping outside of his will. But when you step outside of his will, the demons have opportunity to attack you.
Yes.
We give them room to flood us. Hallelujah. That's why when you backslide, you turn stupid. I tell you, I was stupid for a season. I did not know God. I forgot. I grew up as a babe, but when I outgrew myself, church, you know,
Amen.
You know, children, it happens. Don't let it happen to you if you possibly can. It's a real silly thing to do.
Amen.
Trust me.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I didn't remember the name of Jesus. And I was out there in my own strength, fighting my own battle. And let me tell you, he whooped me so hard. I praise God every time I think about good he's been and he waited on me. He kept on reaching out and rescuing me. My God, I should have died. but God. He had a plan all along to save my soul. Put a mic in my hand. I tell them not run off. Go tell them what you see. Go tell the world about me. Tell them that I love you and I will love them too. Go tell the world that Jesus cares, for he died to save it. That enemy beat me down. Ha! That's exactly it. He's not afraid. The only thing Satan's afraid of is Jesus. So when you're in Jesus, think about it. When we're fully armored with Jesus, what can he do? The Bible said no weapons. Come on. He is the one that's coming at us with the weapon. No weapon formed against us can prosper because we are in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, bless the name of Jesus. When the Spirit of the Lord is in the place, when our vessels are fully and armored with the Lord, when we're walking according to his word and doing his will, all the enemy can do is walk by us, fly over us. He can go all around, but he can't touch you because the Lord is for you. And he said, if God be for me, said the word, then who can be against me? Church, we are God's children. We are the house of the living God. In this place, we worship him. We live for him. We give thanks to him. We recognize his glory. Hallelujah. Woo. Oh, for the peace of God that passes all understanding. Oh, for the peace of God and the purpose of God to know that although I'm walking and it looks as though I can't make it, it looks as though I'm not going to accomplish, praise God, but because I'm in him, because my steps are ordered by him, I can't lose. I said I can't lose. The battle is not yours or mine. This battle belongs to the Lord. He's the one that fought in the battle. And the Bible tells me that every knee will bow and every tongue got to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, whether they be in the heaven, beneath the earth, or in the midst of it. Hallelujah. What a God we serve. What a risen Savior. What is he to us? He is the Lord our God. So our plans must not be without the Lord, for he is the one that determines our steps. So we have to commit. We have to refer. We have to give all of our actions and concerns to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We have to make a, bless God, our calling and election sure. Praise be to God. Amen. The final outcome, hallelujah, is in his hand. He has brought us thus far. Praise God. And he will continue to bring us out. He will establish us in the end. Hallelujah. We have wisdom from God. Man's wisdom cannot take us through. For man's wisdom, it will perish. But the wisdom of God is from all eternity. He will allow us to accomplish our plans in him. Hallelujah. He knows what you need. He knows how to bring it. He knows when to bring it. If you're going through now, understand that if you're in the Lord your God, if Jesus is your Savior, your steps are established. Your steps are already established. Your walk can't fail. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You ought to be joyful. Hallelujah. Knowing that the total release of all of your plan is in the hand of God. Hallelujah. He had power to bring us through. First Peter 5 and 7 said, we are to give all of our worries. And I'm just putting it this way. It says in actual fact, cast all your cares upon him, for he cares for you. So he said we are to give all of our worries and concerns, all of our cares to God.
Yes, thank you,
Jesus.
Hallelujah. That song began to hold in my head as I woke up now before I went to bed last night. We have an anchor that holds in the storms of life. We have an anchor that holds in the storms of life. See, our ship can't sink. Oh my God.
Amen.
I love it. I said our ship can't sink. Satan can bore holes in our ship. Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Satan can make holes in our ship. He can fill it with sand. He can pour all kind of stuff in it. But when it's anchored in the man Christ Jesus, I tell you, we're going to ride out the storm. Those waves can't sink the ship. I said, if it's got hold, if your ship feels like you're taking on water, you look down like the disciples did. See, the Bible is written for us so that we can compare our lives to it. And then we can see how they overcame. Hallelujah. Come on. That's why we have the word of God. That's why you've got to read it. You've got to know what it says so that you can win the battle in the time of your storm.
Hallelujah.
Holes are all over. The storm, the water's coming in. Oh my God, the more you pour it out, the more it comes in. The more you pour it out, the more it comes in. And you're beginning to feel like one more drop. And I'm going to overturn. Ah, hallelujah. But I hear the word of God said, the Lord has a plan for us. Hallelujah. And he has established our steps. For we are good men. Because we are in Christ Jesus. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. They are fixed. They are established. They are unmovable. So when I'm in the Lord, I cannot be moved. I cannot be shaken. I cannot be taken down. For when I step into the boat, hallelujah, the one that holds the boat on the stormy water, he's in there with me. And it might look like he's sleeping for a season, but I just want to tell you, trust him.
Hallelujah. Amen, amen, amen.
Commit
amen.
All your ways unto the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That means everything.
Amen.
Some of us think there are things that are too small. We can't tell Jesus about it. I don't want to bother him with that. I can't tell the Lord about this.
Amen.
This is trivial.
Tell it to him. Amen.
But he said, the disciples said, the one who wanted to walk on the water with Jesus, the one who was in the boat when it started to shake, hallelujah, and when they see him master, they thought he was a goat. But when he recognized him, he knew who hold the water. They said, let me come. Let me come. I want to come to you. You know, the little excited children.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I see you walking on water. I want to walk on water too.
Amen.
See, when we come to Jesus, that's what we come to do. Church. To walk on water with him.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. To walk on the waves with him.
Yes.
Come on. When we come to Jesus, it ain't time for a flowery bed to be. It ain't time for us to sit back and cross our legs and pretend we're in our place. No, we're not there yet.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
So we got to walk on the water with it. If you're like me, you're scared of a big body of water. I got a pool and I look at the deep end like it did something to me. I love the shallow end because I'm in control. Tell me about halfway down the pool, I'm like, I'm not ready. But I have power over the deep end as much as I have power over the shallow end if I trust in the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So we are fixed. We're planted on the rock. Hallelujah. We're like Peter. We put our hand in the hand of the one that stills the water. We put our hand in the hand of the one who calms the sea. Come on, church. We're putting our hand in the hand of the one who calms the sea. Who is like our Lord? Who can be like Jesus? Are your feet established in Christ? Hallelujah. He cares about you. When your anchor is in him, you can be sure that you will not fail. Hallelujah. When you cast all your care on Jesus, your soul will be kept at peace. Come on, church. It's time the church be in peace. It's time we know that we know that we know that we know that we can't fail.
Amen.
Though we're walking on the water, we gotta know we're not going down, but going up. It's time that we have the joy that fills us. Although our boat is still filled with water, we are steadfast and sure while the billows roll, because we are fastened to the rock which cannot move, because it's grounded firm and deep in the Savior's love.
Hallelujah.
We have an anchor that fills the soul or keeps the soul steadfast and sure while the billows roll. Hallelujah. God's got you.
Amen.
I said God's got you.
Amen.
He's got our backs.
Yes.
Hallelujah. The tide might be high right now, but know that you've got a God who is able to hold you up in the storm. He's able to establish you in the storm. Hallelujah. He will not permit the godly to slip and fall out of his way. When your steps are ordered, you can't walk any and anywhere. You can't do any and anything. When your steps are being ordered by the Lord, your mind might tell you one thing. But because your feet is steadfastly on the rock, though your mind's saying go over there, your foot's not moving. Your heart's not going with it. That's why your foot can't move, because it's fastened to the rock.
Amen.
It is steadfast and sure. So your mind is saying the pasture looks greener over there. I want to go in the pasture over there. Hallelujah. I want to receive the things that are over there. But you can't move because you're fastened to the rock. Hallelujah. So you're fastened to the rock. You just hold on. You're just staying there. You want to quit. You want to give up. You want to try something else. Because that thing ain't working. I've been doing it so long. God, I've been waiting so long. That's me. I'm waiting. How long? How much more do I have to wait, Lord? Wake up. Wait so long. support children. But I can't move because I'm planted on the rock. My heels are fastened to the rock. So though the enemies will try to, you know, when you hear the ungodly thing, you know it's that demon that's flying about and he's trying to shoot out little arrows to unnerve you and to move you over the path that God ordered for you.
Yes.
He's trying to pick you up from where he planted you on the rock and move you to sinking sand. So when the storm blows, you're hallelujah. What a God.
Amen.
What a God.
Amen.
I know the plans I have for you.
Yes.
He said to us, thus saith the Lord, I know the plans. Yes. Only he knows your beginning,
yes,
your middle, and your end.
Amen.
Only he knows that if you walk with him through the valley and the shadow of death, you're coming out all done up, Lord Jesus. You can imagine you went in with some old raggedy clothes, looking all beaten up and shaken up. Here all a mess. Makeup all over the place. Come on, church. But when you come out, you're robed in. Help me up in here. When you come out, you're coming out all dressed in white. You're coming out like a bride. You're coming out all done up. The men got on their white robe. When you're on the rock, when you're fasting, understand that the next time you see yourself, you're going to be like Jesus. You're going to become the bride of Christ. I just want to remind you why you're running. Hallelujah. Are you established? Are your steps established? If you're feeling shaky, if you're feeling unnerved, dig deep. Dig deep. He will not allow us to slip out of his path. He doesn't want us to fall off of the ship. He doesn't want us to be sidetracked. When your steps are established, your enemy cannot divert your steps. It cannot change the plans of God. Who knows that? We let, if the plans God have for us change, it's because we let go of his hand and stop walking in his plan. Matthew 6 and 33 said we are to seek first the kingdom of God and all of his righteousness, and all other things will be added unto us. We ought to find wisdom. The wisdom of God. Wisdom will be your best friend. And wisdom is found in the word of God, telling us how to stay and walk order in him. Hallelujah. It is the Lord who makes firm your steps. There is no power on earth, no principality, no demon, no devil that can uproot the ones whose steps are established in the Lord. Come on here.
Amen.
Don't be shaken. I said no principality, no demon, no devil. I don't care who he seemed to be. He's not all that. Isaiah said, oh, was it you that caused the brethren to tremble? You? That tells me ain't nothing great.
Amen.
That tells me ain't nothing to look at. He's just trying to fool you that he got some power. He can only do what the one with all power allows him to do. And if he allows him to do it, it's so that he might establish his plans for your life and show the enemy that he's greater. His name is Jesus.
Amen.
His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. We've got to be firmly planted in the steps of Him, our Lord. Scripture said, no weapon formed against you can prosper. He will not allow your foot to be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber nor sleep. Psalms 121 verse 3. He who keeps you will not slumber or sleep. He don't get tired, church. It's not like us. After a couple of hallelujah praise, we're too tired. No, that's not what he does. He never sleeps. He never gets weary. He don't get tired of us. The Lord will preserve your going out and your coming in from this time forward and forevermore. Psalm 121 verse 8. The Lord will preserve your going out and your coming in. Wherever you are, he's there. Hallelujah. Make your plans with him. Don't ever plan without him. Commit your all to the Lord so that you can live in safety. Find joy and rest for your soul. Commit all your ways unto the Lord.
Amen.
Not some. He's not a sometimes God.
Amen.
He's an all time God.
Amen.
He never sleeps. He never gets weary. He's always on your side. He's always looking out for you. He said, call unto me and I will hear you and answer, says the Lord. Call unto me. Hallelujah. In all things with prayer, supplications, make your requests known unto God.
Amen.
Oh, sweet. Oh, how sweet to trust in Jesus.
Amen.
Just to take him at his word. Just to lean upon his promise. Just to know, thus says the Lord. And it's time for us to understand that we cannot be shaken if we're established in him. Let your steps be always ordered. Walk according to his will, according to his plan. And I guarantee you, you will come out more than a conqueror, fully robed in the blessing of our God. God bless you today.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God keep you today. May he cause his face to shine upon you and give you his peace.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In all your ways, acknowledge him. And he will direct your path. Stand to you.